Hi there. Today we're going to have a look at how to install Zigbee to MQTT on the latest release of Home Assistant in 2024. So over the 3 years that I've been using Home Assistant, I've been using the ZHA Zigbee integration. And now I've decided to try out Zigbee to MQTT because I have had some issues with some of my battery devices falling off ZHA. So let's have a go. So in order to set up Zigbee to MQTT, we need a couple of things. First thing we need is obviously our Home Assistant server. I'm running a Raspberry Pi 4. Next, we need a dongle. So I've decided to go with the Sonoff ZB Dongle E, which is one of the supported devices. What we're going to do is we're going to plug this into our Home Assistant. I always recommend restarting Home Assistant once you've done this. It is advisable to use one of these extension cables to position the Zigbee radio away from your Home Assistant so that you don't get any interference. So first of all, I'm going to go along to Settings, Add-on Store, and search for MQTT, and click on the Mosquito Broker, and press Install. And now I'm going to start the add-on, and click the Watchdog. So now we're going to install the Zigbee to MQTT add-on. So we go to Add-ons, and we go to the Add-on Store. And then what you do is paste the link in the description below into the repository over here. So I paste that in and I add that. Next, I just refresh my screen and there we see Zigbee to MQTT. Now don't worry about these two, it's this one here. So you click on that and we want to go install. So now that it's installed, we just click the watchdog and the show in sidebar. We go along here to configuration. And now we paste in that little piece of code that I've included in the description below. We line that up there. And the adapter here is because I'm using the Sonoff E type dongle. If you're using the other type, I think it's a P, you wouldn't need this. And if you're using an SM Lite, for example, there's a separate piece of code that you stick in over here. Now what we want to do is go along and find the address of the USB hardware. So we go Settings, System, Hardware, All Hardware, and this is the one over here. So we're going to check down here and we're going to copy this ID address over here. So copy that, and that's going to be pasted in just over here. And then we're going to go save. So now that's saved, we can go back here to the Info tab and we can start. You can click on your log. And if you scroll down here, you should be able to see what's going on here. Just give a little bit of time to start up. And there we go. Zigbee to MQTT has started. So now that it's started, we can go along to the Zigbee to MQTT over here. And it's all ready to go. Now, from here, what we can do is we can press the Permit to Join button. And now for about 4 minutes, it will be searching for devices to be added. So the first thing I'm going to do over here is I'm going to take one of my devices and I'm going to press the pairing button and it should pop up here shortly. So I'm holding down the pairing button so it can go into pairing and we should see this appearing pretty soon. There we go. It's busy starting to interview and it's joined very, very quick. And if we now have a look at this device, we can click on the name of the device. There we go. We've got a Sonoff device. It's an EweLink temperature and humidity sensor. If we go to exposers, you'll see there that it is exposing the battery, the temperature, and the humidity, as well as the link quality. So this is the awesome thing about Zigbee to MQTT, is that it's bringing in a whole lot more different entities for our devices. So now that we've got that all set up, you'll see that it's not actually pulling those devices through to Home Assistant yet. So what we need to do is go along here to Settings, Devices and Services, and you can see there that the MQTT has now popped up and it's asking for configuration in Home Assistant. So we go Configure and Submit. There we go. We'll just put our broker in the kitchen. And now we can see that our device is coming up here. So I'm going to put this device in the bedroom and finish. And there we go. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this episode. I've really enjoyed learning about Zigbee to MQTT, and I look forward to playing with it in the future and hopefully getting much better control over my Zigbee devices. If you've enjoyed this episode, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you again in the next one. Bye for now.